Good morning, this is Sister Sheila, and I'm delighted to welcome you to the Worship Experience today. Thank you so much for joining us. So now join me as we go to our worship experience.
Invite you in this place. Come, Lord, and have thine way, Lord. Send your anointed down, Father, that will heal, deliver, cast out. Send your anointing, God, that will cause us to be give blessings and be blessed. Oh, God, bless us this day, Lord, to bless you in all that we are doing. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. 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 Our hymn this morning is hymn 286. My hope is built on nothing less. Hallelujah. My hope is built on on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ, the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Scripture, we have Acts, the fourth chapter, beginning at the, I'll say the 23rd verse. Acts, the fourth chapter, verses 23 says, when they were released, they went to their friends and reported what the chief priests and the elders had said to them. And when they heard it, they lift up their voices together to God and said, Sovereign Lord, who made the heavens and the earth and the sea and everything in them, who through the mouth of babes, our fathers, David, your servant said, by the Holy Spirit, why did the Gentiles rage and the people plot in vain? The king on the earth set themselves and the rulers were together against the Lord and against the anointed. Verse 27 says, for truly in this city, these were gathered together against your holy servant Jesus, whom you anointed, both Herod, Pilate, along with the Gentiles and the people of Israel, to do whatever your hands and your palm has predestined to take place. And now, Lord, look upon their threats and grant to your servant to continue to speak your words with all boldness. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The word of God for the people of God. Amen. Let us pray now. O gracious God and eternal Father, God of our fathers, God of the universe, God of the whole world, have mercy upon us. Lord, for we realize, Father, that we are humans and that we have made mistakes, that we are weak, but thou art mighty. Oh God, make us strong, Father, oh, so we can worship you. Make us strong, Lord, where we can lift your name up, Lord, and do the right things, God. Make us strong, Lord, where we can forgive each other, God. Oh, Father God, we ask it now, Lord, oh, to meet all of our needs right now, Lord. Oh, Father God, you know more about our needs than we know ourselves. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy. Then too, Lord, we want to ask you, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, fight for us, God. Fight for us in the physical realm and spiritual realm. Fight for us against all sickness and diseases. Fight for us, God, in this earthly realm, God. And have mercy upon us. Have mercy, God. Oh, God, give us a spirit, God. A spirit of praising you, God. A spirit of giving you thanks, God. A spirit of worshiping you, God. Oh, Father God, we ask you right now, God. Lord, don't let us be the same, Lord. Lord, make us stronger right now, God. Oh, Father, in your matchless name. Holy Spirit, intercede for us right now. For you know about our needs and our want more than what we know. Holy Spirit, Al, we ask it now in the name of Jesus. Have mercy, have mercy, have mercy. Amen, amen, amen.
Taking care of me. He's all
in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask you for your blessings this day, God. Lord, we ask you to use us, God, to bless people, to bless ourselves, to bless your kingdom. Oh God, we ask you for a special anointing right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, we ask you, God, to solve problems, God, solve issues, God. Oh God, make the difference, because we know, Father God, that there is nothing too hard for you to do in the name of Jesus. Oh, we just thank God. We thank God for everything and everyone. We just thank God for another opportunity. Here you'll find us today in Acts, the 4th chapter. And we're going to begin probably right around the 23rd verse. Acts 4th chapter, 23rd verse. And my subject today will be, don't be afraid. We all know that God can't use no one that's afraid. So if you are afraid, we need to ask God and pray and ask him to help us and give us the holy boldness. I know there's a lot of people that's afraid to do a lot of things. But God, pray and ask God. And God will give you the holy boldness. I'm a living witness of it. Amen. Praise God. Let us begin. Amen. I'll read a little bit. Amen. Acts, the 4th chapter. I'm going to begin with the 23rd verse. Says, and being let go, they went their own company. They went to their own company and reported all that the chief priests and elders said to them. Hallelujah. And when they heard that, they lift up their voices to God with one accord, church, one accord, and said, Lord, thou art God, which has made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them is the Lord's. Hallelujah. I just want to thank God today, for being able to go through this message and talking about don't be afraid. You'll be surprised how many people are afraid of certain things. Hallelujah. But I thank God for his holy boldness that he has given us. Hallelujah. We said, a 26th verse says, the king of the earth stood up, and the rulers were gathered together against the Lord and his church. For of a truth again, thy holy child Jesus, whom thou hast anointed, both Herod and Pilate, hallelujah, with the Gentiles and the people of Israel were gathered together, hallelujah. We're going to get our boldness, holy boldness from Jesus. Hallelujah. Who came down to die for us. Hallelujah. Oh, thank God. God is an awesome God. Hallelujah. He said that, and now the Lord behold their threats and granted unto thy servant that with all boldness may speak thy words. Hallelujah. When we get ready to speak the words of God, ask God to help you to be holy bold and to go on in. Hallelujah. And do what thus says the Lord. By stretching forth thy hands to heal, and that signs and wonders may be done by the name of thy holy child, Jesus. So I'm here to tell you that Jesus is where we're going to get our power from. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. He says, and when they had prayed, the place was shaken. Hallelujah. Where they were assembling together, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. And they spoke with words of God with boldness. And I'm a living witness today, church. God will make you bold. He'll give you that holy boldness. Hallelujah. So don't worry about being afraid. God will fix it. Hallelujah. He'll fix it. Oh, thank you, Jesus. once I was saved at a very early age. And the reason why I got saved, because I was afraid. And I knew, I just believed that God would give me the holy boldness to do all that needs to be done. So I gave my life to the Lord. And I'm here to tell you today, amen, God has truly given me holy boldness. And if I know, if he's given it to me, he'll give it to you. Praise God. Praise God. Let us look now at the 32nd verse. It says, and the multitude of them that believe were all of one heart and of one soul. Neither said any to them that thou art the things which he possesses was in his own, but they had all things in common. That's what I love about Christians, amen. God has given us something in common. Hallelujah. And that's his spirit. Hallelujah. His spirit don't act different. His spirit is the same. And what I love about a church, you will know. Every Christian will know God's spirit when they get around other saints. Amen. And what got me so about this chapter was verse 33. It says, and with great power was given to the apostles. And if I could change it, with great power was given to the saints, amen, to the witnesses of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And great grace, that's what we need, church. We need great grace. I know that will take away all the fear when we got faith in Jesus Christ. And he'll give us his great grace was upon all of them. Hallelujah. That's what we need today, church. We need grace. Hallelujah. Now, President Trump could come out with all kind of laws that he could, amen. But we need the grace of God. Hallelujah. The power to keep us. The power that will cause us to do things better than they ever was done before. Hallelujah. We find here that the disciples, amen, they had great power. Great power was given to the apostles. Hallelujah. We see that this great grace was given to the saints. Hallelujah. In the old days and now. Hallelujah. The great grace was given. Hallelujah. If you don't believe we need grace now, amen, just look at the news. Hallelujah. Of the things that's happened to people, the things that's what people are going through. We need the grace of God. Hallelujah. And that's why we can say, don't be afraid. We've got God's grace. We've got the presence of God in our lives and on our lives. Hallelujah. I just can't get over it, amen, of all the marching that was done this month, last month, hallelujah, last week, hallelujah. Oh, on the death of this individual by the police, hallelujah. And we find that God's grace power kept those people, amen. Because before then, amen, when you're doing a march like that, so many people went to jail. And so many people, the police hurt, hallelujah. But God's grace was on the different individuals that kept them from being hurt. Hallelujah. Sure, maybe one lose their lives. Amen. But God's grace was right there. Amen. Because a lot of others should have been dead. Hallelujah. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of nothing. Hallelujah. Because God's grace, hallelujah, has got you. Hallelujah. I'm reminded in the Old Testament about one of our servants by the name of David. Hallelujah. David was a little fellow. Hallelujah. But he loved God. Is there anybody here today that loves God? loves God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I tell you, David loved God so much until he wrote the 23rd Psalm. It's something special about the 23rd Psalm. I know I heard of a woman that was getting ready to go into an operation. So she started repeating the 23rd Psalms. They put her to sleep saying the 23rd Psalms. And when they woke up, when she woke up saying the 23rd Psalm. So I'm here to tell you today, church, don't be afraid about anything. The Lord is on your side. He promised to be with you. Hallelujah. The 23rd Psalms, he was with David. And when by being with David, Saul was trying to kill him, God. David had to run from Saul night and day. And Saul just wanted to get rid of David. Why? Because David was anointed by God. God had put his special touch on David. Just like some of you and I, God has touched us. He has touched our lives, hallelujah. And we've got the mark of Jesus in our lives. But back to this 23rd Psalms, I heard David when he said, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want.
Come on.
I heard it when he said, he maketh me to lie down in the green pastures. He led me beside the still waters. He restored my soul.
Yes.
He led me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. That's what you got to say to yourself sometime when you get into those situations. When you are afraid, you got to say, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemy. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. I heard David when he also said, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. For he has founded it upon the sea and established it upon the flood. I'm here to tell you today, church, there's no need to fear, for God is in charge. God is in charge of our lives. There's no need to fear. He was in charge of the apostle lives. He was in charge of everything that we turn over to him. All we got to do is just ask him to come and take control and believe in our hearts that he will. I'm here to tell you today, the Lord will be with you. He was with the woman that was having an operation. Oh, she repeated, the Lord is my shepherd, all while she was going through. And when she woke up, they were finished. I'm here to tell you today, the Lord will stand by you. If you only lift him up, he'll make a way for you. Don't be afraid. There's nothing to be afraid of. God has got us all wrapped up for in his arms. God has got us, and there's nothing under the sun could take us away from God. No, no, there's nothing. God will give us power when we're weak. God will give us holy boldness when we're weak. God will give us strength when we're all torn down. God will give us holy boldness. I thank God for Jesus today. I thank God for him. For without God, I would be nothing. Without God, I can do nothing. God is the God that will make you bold. God is the God that takes away all the fears from you. Just trust in him. He will deliver you. Oh, yeah. Maybe there's some time when you have to do something for God and you are a little afraid, like praying for somebody. I'm here to tell you today, just close your eyes and trust in the Lord. Lay your hands on the sick person and just begin to call on Jesus and asking him to help you. Just trust totally in the Lord. He'll come and see about you. He will deliver the sick person. That's what kind of God that we're serving. He won't let you down, just like he didn't let the apostles down. Oh yeah, when the priests and were trying to kill the apostles, God was right there to protect them. Even one of them cut off of the high priest's ear. The guards that when they went to get Jesus, they cut off the high priest's ear. Oh yeah, Jesus reached down and picked it up and put it right back on. I'm here to tell you today, church, don't be afraid. The Lord has not changed. He's still the change. He's still the same. He'll make a way out of no way. Somebody may have financial problems, money a little low. Just trust in God. Pray and seek his face. The Lord will make a way. You're somebody special, so you don't have to be afraid. God is here. Oh, hallelujah. 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 I thank God. I thank God today. I praise his name. I give him glory, for he is an awesome weapon. He is. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Praise God. We thank God for the word of God that came through our pastor. At this time, I just feel in my spirit that there is someone out there that's ready to accept Jesus as their personal Savior. And if you are, why don't you repeat after me? Dear God, I'm a sinner. Forgive me of my sins. Lord, I realize that you died for my sins, and then you rose again with all power in your hands. So God, I'm also asking you to not only save me, but to fill me with your precious Holy Ghost. And I will give you all the praises and all the honor. I thank you. In Jesus' name I do pray. Amen. Amen. If you believe, hallelujah, what you just repeated, you are saved. Hallelujah. You are now a part of God's body. Why don't you call the number that's on the screen, and there will be someone there to rejoice with you and fellowship with you into the new body of Christ. Next, if you'd like to join our church, why don't you call this number, and there's someone there that will be ready and willing to welcome you here at St. James Hillman Zion Church. We'll be glad to have you a part. And last, if you desire prayer, call this number, and there will be someone there to pray with you, because we realize that prayer is the key and it changes things. Ways that you can give to this ministry is through Givelify. PayPal. You're gonna make it. God's gonna see you through. Hold your head up. Put a smile on your face. This is another test. Or you can come by the church and drop it off. It's gonna be on next Sunday. Next Sunday is Father's Day, and we welcome all our fathers to watch next Sunday's service. It's a tribute to all our fathers. So everyone that's out there watching, get your fathers on, get your brothers on, get your uncles on, whoever that's a father, have them to watch next Sunday's service. God bless you.
God is a good God. He is so good until no matter what we do, we ought to thank God and ask God for his blessings. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. We thank you and we bless your name. Lord, be with us and go with us. Keep us. And whenever we call on you, Lord, I know you'll be right there. And we'll be careful to give you all the praise and all the glory. Amen, amen, amen. God bless you. God keep you until we meet again. In Jesus' name, amen.
Through. Hold your head up, put a smile on.